tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats, Super Comic David William, Supermodel Jody Kidd, and their team captain, Jason Manford. And facing them tonight, he's a brainiac, Vic Reeves. We've hired him. It's Rafe. And their team captain, Sean Locke. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy Carr.
Well, hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats, a show about opinion polls, surveys and statistics. Did you know, for example, the minimum pay for a prisoner in a British jail is £4 per week? They say crime doesn't pay, but it does. £4 a week. The average German wakes up at 6:23 a.m. Well, it's difficult to sleep with all that on your conscience. And 40% of people use their mobile phone to cheat on their partner. I use Mr. Tinkle. Let's get started. What are you talking about? That's the name of our first round. We've teamed up with a leading polling organisation and they've asked the British nation what stories they've been discussing this week. It's our panellist's job to guess the British public's top five most popular talking points. Jason's team to go first. What stories have people been discussing this week?
There's a new show called Big Brother.
Yeah. It's really cutting edge.
It's about people sharing a house together and then afterwards their lives are ruined. I like Mikey. The blind one. Only thing is, he dresses up as a woman to be funny, and I think that's a bit desperate.
If you've got a disability on Big Brother, then you're a shoo-in to win, really. I mean, Pete with his Tourette's, Nadia had a penis, not strictly a... not strictly a disability, but it is if you want to be a woman, right? So, I know it's early days, but I think if Mikey doesn't win, I will show my arse in Primark window.
There's one interesting character, it's the albino guy, Darnell. Apparently, he got involved in gangs and crime in America, and I was thinking, if you're an albino, the last thing you should do is get involved in crime. Because you're always going to get caught, aren't you? Even if you had a balaclava on with a tiny little eye hole. That bloke with the pink eye, the albino. It was him. And I was thinking, what if he was in a gang of albinos? There was just this old albino gang that used to come sort of drifting like a cloud down the street.
When I first turned on Big Brother this year, I did think the house was haunted.
I like Don.
Don, which one's that, Vic?
I haven't seen it, but I just want to join in with it.
The other thing was that they got very upset about when the blind guy picked up the knickers, didn't they? Mm. He picked up some girl's knickers and she said it lacked respect.
Did she have them on at the time?
Well, no, that's the thing. It would lack respect if they were in a knicker drawer, she was wearing them, they're on a laundry line, but she'd thrown them on the floor. If you've thrown them on the floor, technically they're flotsam. Anyone can take them. They're actually, I think legally, they're the property of the British Navy.
Mikey, he's got a sideline, apparently, of selling Nazi memorabilia.
What?
So we digress.
That's the whole show, is digressing.
Digressing.
I'm not just trying to nail the answers and move on. It's not a task.
It's not a task.
Right, well, let's have a look and see whether Big Brother is one of the most talked about things of the week. Big Brother is back. Bullying Alex is now officially the most hated housemate in history. On hearing the news, Nasty Nick went out and drop-kicked a kitten into an orphan's face. Sean, Vic, Rafe, what else have the nation been talking about this week?
I guess on the topic of reality television, Lee, that's what I'm talking about, McQueen winning The Apprentice.
He's never said that's what I'm talking about. He says, that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Did you watch any of The Apprentice?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I never had my finger away from the button where it was on.
I like Don.
That's a good one, didn't he?
Yeah.
The thing I like best about Saran and Sugar is he's mental. Clearly, he's mental. Because he brings them together. He goes, right, you're probably wondering why we're at the Tate Modern. That's right, we're making fudge. Yeah, you're probably wondering why we're at Duxford Air Museum. That's right, children's coffins.
It's all part of his policy to try and intimidate.
Yeah, and why did you have to do everything on a weird fax phone?
Weird fax
phone? You had to make all the phone calls in the series using, like that, using...
Using a normal telephone with the loudspeaker function switched on.
It's terrible. It's terrible when twins fall out.
Get a little bit unnerved by Nick and Margaret always like hiding behind plant pots just taking notes. And even when it was something they didn't even care about, like you could be washing cars and they'd be going.
What were you doing before you were on The Apprentice?
I thought he was the ENTS officer in 8½ Hot Mum. It might just be me. You know, sometimes grammatical things annoy you. His catchphrase is "You're fired," yet you haven't got the job yet. So, really, it shouldn't be "you're fired" because it's about trying to get the job. It should be "you're not on The Apprentice show anymore." That's what it should be.
You're right, of course.
It's a bit like... Thank you. It's a bit like... You remember Bruce Forsyth's catchphrase was "nice to see you nice." It doesn't make any sense. What it should be is "nice to see you." No, really, it's "nice to see you." It's the same
That's why
problem.
He's never going to get fucking anywhere, surely. Yes, yes. Well, let's have a look and see whether The Apprentice is one of the most talked about things this week. So it is, the fifth most talked about thing this week. Yes, The Apprentice ended this week. Tragically, due to a mix-up at the BBC, the winner of The Apprentice is going to be playing Nancy in a West End production of Oliver. Jason, Jodie, David, what else have the nation been talking about this week?
Hillary Clinton, would you think?
Yeah. Hillary Obama. Clinton?
Yeah.
Would you have liked to have seen her win?
No, I like Obama, actually. I think he's cool.
Once you've had black, you don't go back, do you? Maybe I shouldn't have
said
that.
I think it should be his new slogan.
No, that would be the second term.
The second term.
His slogan at the moment is "Yes, we can," which, if I recall, is also Bob the Builders.
There was something bizarre which made me laugh. In the Washington Post, it said something along the lines of "Hillary Clinton gives Obama..."
In the Washington Post? Maybe you should spend a bit of less time. I just check
it.
What's up
New York every morning, bye.
I think you might have got the fucking job if you haven't been reading the Washington Post and concentrated on the task.
On the task, yeah, too busy. Now, I said something along the lines of "Hillary Clinton gives Obama her full-throated support," and I thought, well, if she only gave that to Bill, he wouldn't have buggered off with Monica. Completely bizarre.
Let's see how many people were talking about the US presidential election this week. Oh, quite a lot. Yeah, third most talked about thing. Yes, this is the story that Barack Obama has defeated Hillary Clinton and won the Democratic presidential nomination. Hillary has been an inspiration. She's shown women around the world that there are limits. It was all going so well for Hillary until that kosher chicken task in Morocco. Sean, what else have the nation been talking about?
Is it the oil strike?
Petrol.
Is oil and petrol the same thing?
Yeah.
I don't know. Because you put petrol in one place and oil in another in a car.
Yeah.
They're not the same thing.
Different. Oil.
They say we're running out of oil.
Petrol's fine, you think?
Well, are they the same? Are they the same thing? I don't
know. So you think they might be? We're running out of oil, but there's loads of petrol left.
No, but people say oil, and they mean petrol.
Well, calm down. Sorry, if people are watching this at home, don't worry about the fuel crisis because we've got loads of petrol.
No, is it the same thing?
Yes.
Just to clear it up, there is a fuel tankers strike, and all the papers said don't panic, which meant everybody's panicked.
Can you stockpile petrol? I don't know.
Can you stockpile it?
Yeah, can you
really
fill
your car up to your chest? You actually fill the whole car up because you're driving like you're underwater. Everything's going up. Food's going up. Everything's going up, up.
Children's shoes have increased in price, and I really don't know why, because I buy children's shoes all the time. But they're the same price as adult shoes. A brief history of shoes. We all know that they start off that big, then they grow to that big, and then they get that big, like, for adult size, and then if you leave them in a cave in Holland, we all know that they grow bigger and bigger and eventually turn out as cars. which is why the petrol is so expensive.
Just to point out, Vix recently had the bends. In a diving accident.
Let's have a look and see if petrol is one of the most talked about things of the week. Yes, it is the most talked about thing this week. Yes, of course, everyone's talking about petrol prices soaring and the threat of a strike. Panic buying at garages is exacerbating the problem. The government want to reassure people supplies of Gingsters and Rizzlers are unaffected. OK, fingers on buzzers. One more thing to get. What else have the nation been talking about?
Colleen and Wayne Rooney have got married.
Yeah.
And did you know that they searched all the guests for mobile phones and cameras when they came in? Nothing to do with the magazine deal, which is the Scouse way of doing things.
If you're watching in Liverpool, buy a TV licence. I was there last weekend and we're not back for another year. European City of Culture. I came back, the car was up on books.
I've actually never seen Wayne Rooney speak. Can he speak?
Sort of, yeah.
Because he's got to do the vows and everything, hasn't he?
Yeah, he wrote his own vows.
What did he say? I'm joking.
They did do their own vows. They both said, what's mine is yours and what's
yours is mine.
Is also mine. And I think Colleen must have been going...
I mean, he's only going to get
a couple of handbags.
The wedding cost £5 million.
Yeah.
And I was thinking, that was on a Thursday. Imagine how much it would have cost on a Saturday. Saturday, it'd have been 10 at least. Every guest has a little box with a butterfly in it, and at a crucial moment, right, they have to open the box and a butterfly flies out. You see, what a great job for an Italian butterfly collector. We want you to collect... I can't do accents.
no, do it in the accent.
100 butterflies. He goes, oh, I love a collector butterfly. He goes, what's he for? It's a Wayne Rooney's wedding. You get 100 butterflies, you put them in a little itty-teeny box. How the hell do you get a butterfly into a box?
Just ask it nicely.
You just go...
That's why it's cost £5 million. Yeah. They got the food at Iceland.
Yeah.
Well, let's have a look and see how many people were talking about Wayne and Colleen getting married. It's the wedding of the year. Yes, Colleen and Wayne have finally tied the knot. Colleen is the face of Asda. Wayne is the face of Bags of Spanners. On the night of the wedding, there was a £50,000 firework display. Unfortunately, Wayne missed it as he had to be kept indoors. So, at the end of that round, I can tell you it's 2 points for Sean's team and 3 points for Jason's team. Our next round is called Pick of the Polls. Our teams take it in turns to choose a picture from the board and then have to answer a related question. Sean, Vic and Rafe, your turn first. What do you fancy going for?
The naked couple emerging happily from the tent.
This is a word association question. I'm looking for the top word or phrase the public said when we said camping.
David Williams.
The you.
Are you camp?
No.
No.
No. No. No. No. No.
Rain.
I'm going to give you that because it's the word most associated with camping is wet. Yeah. Make sure when you go camping, you have a ground sheet and a hammer so you can dispose of the person who suggested going camping. OK, what picture do you want to go for, Jason Steen?
I think we're going to go with... is it Fern Britton there? She actually got her gastric band on there. Is that all right?
You've chosen Fern Britton. This is an audience poll question. We polled the studio audience and asked them, if you had a gastric band fitted, would you keep it a secret from your friends?
Jodie?
Yeah.
Yours has gone brilliantly, Jodie. Because you were a reet fat lass a few years ago. You've really slimmed down.
I think I would. From my friends, yeah.
Mm. You wouldn't tell them, you would tell them?
I would.
Oh, that. All right, OK.
Yeah, trustworthy ones. I wouldn't, you know, I wouldn't sit there in the pub and blab it out, you know.
I've got my gastric band in.
It's like a Jubilee clip, isn't it? It's like putting a Jubilee clip round your stomach.
Jubilee clip?
It's a Jubilee clip, you screw it in...
He's like a proper bloke. Dawn is like someone's dad. Who knows that?
The old 4x2 with the old clip, yeah, old Jubilee, yeah.
Yeah, you're right, you've got any Jubilee clips, yeah.
Old Jubilee clip when he old
Jubilee
mate.
Jubilee clip, what are you talking about?
Everyone knows what a Jubilee clip is.
I don't know what a Jubilee clip is.
It's a Jubilee clip, shut it!
Well, it's like a Jubilee clip around your stomach, but much more expensive.
The same effect if you put a lot of elastic bands around your tongue. Like, your tongue sticks out and it's, like, really tight. You can't eat.
She's in a lot of trouble, isn't she?
She's not in serious trouble, not with the police or anything.
But why are they upset?
Because, and I'll tell you, Sean, because this is something I don't know about petrol and oil, but I know about Firm Britain.
Should be on your grave, that. Not suggesting you should die, but I'm saying...
I will one day.
As your
I'll think about that. Thank you.
I love Firm Britain. Okay. I loved her big, and I love her now, OK? The only thing is, because she advertised Ryvita and she did sort of things about slimming, but she didn't say she'd had the gastric band.
Firm Britain, for me, is the person I fancy... You know that sort of person
like a sexy auntie.
Like that, but without the incest connotation.
So she's your secret...
She's
sexy!
She's the... I've got two of them, her and Burt Reynolds. And the two people I sort of fancy or shouldn't. Yeah.
OK, so what do you think? If you had a gastric band fitted, would you keep it a secret?
I think no.
No, don't look. Don't look at...
No, I'm not looking. I'm looking at Rafe, who's like a beautiful, dusky version of you.
So, we've asked the audience, if you had a gastric band fitted, would you keep it a secret from your friends? Yes,
yes or no? Yes and no. Yes and no.
No. No, you wouldn't keep it a secret. OK.
No.
I can tell you the answer is no. 68% said no. Fern Britton recently had a gastric band fitted to one of her stomachs. I say gastric band, it was actually the fan belt from a Boeing 747. At the end of that round, I can tell you that Sean, Vic and Rafe have 3 points, Jason, David and Jody have 4 points. Join me after the break when we'll be finding out if men would rather go shopping or play sport. Of 10 cats. The next round is Believe It or Not. In this round, I give the panellists a simple statement. All they've got to do is tell me whether they think it's true or false. Let's first have a little look at a clip to illustrate the statistic.
Well, here we are today, as you might expect, at the world's finest department store. You'll be seeing this look and many others later on in the show. So until then...
This is one of my autumn predictions. It's a beautiful garment which has these rather strong satin flowers, and I've teamed this outfit with sequin gloves and sequin tights.
Hello.
Karen.
You look brilliant.
Join the club. Yeah. Well, I'm wearing a cropped number this time with a fabric face, you might have noticed.
Why don't you go and put something else on to wow the customers?
What a good idea. What a gorgeously satisfying day this has been, and so many bargains.
That was David Walliams.
No.
That was, in fact, performance artist Lee Bowery on The Clothes Show in 1988. Fashion hasn't caught up with Lee Bowery, but when it does, it's going to kick the shit out of him. Here's your related statistic. 62% of men would rather go shopping than play sport. True or false?
We've been shopping together, haven't we?
We love a bit of
shopping. We've also wrestled together. So we like to
I wasn't really clear
two.
What the rules were there, because it ended really abruptly, and then you never called me.
Is trouser theft considered a sport?
No.
Well, count me in just for 100% shopping.
I don't mind food shopping. Big fan of that. Big
well,
fan
we
of...
can see, yes.
Exactly, you know, I'm a big fan,
David!
Of that.
What do you mean?
Can I say something to you? Is that you do have a stray nostril hair.
Yeah.
And it's like, do you want me to get it for
I
you?
I haven't get it, get it. That. Did you get a little bogey with it?
There, you see that?
That's a bad boy. That's a bad boy.
No, because you don't want to.
So, what are you going to go for? You're
yes.
saying true?
Yes.
Well, hang on. Whose question was it?
It's everybody. To both. Yes.
Well, we're saying yes as well.
Fuck you. We're saying yes.
We're saying yes.
You saying yes?
We're all saying yes, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I can tell you the answer is true. 62% of men would rather go shopping than play sports. Well, point. I'd have to say I agree. If you ever hear me saying City's playing, I mean Sex and the City's on at the Film House. We're meeting at 12 for cocktails. Be there or be square. It's going to be fabulous. So at the end of that round, I can tell you it's 4 points to Sean's team and 5 points for Jason's team. And the winner is the name of our final round. Here's your first one. Top reason Brits are teased at work.
Is it because they say I can work with Prince or Pauper on TV?
That must be right up there, because that would be pretty annoying.
What do you mean by that?
It was basically a dickish way of saying I get on with chalk and cheese.
You get on with chalk and cheese. It's a dickish way of saying you get on with Prince and Pauper.
Is it because they're still quite new, northern, and might have put on a little bit of weight since the last series?
You're lovely.
Thank you.
Where does teasing stop and bullying take over?
When you use a blade.
If someone had a big nose and you just called them Concord, that would be teasing. But if you used it to open a yoghurt pot like that, that would be bullying, wouldn't it?
Top reason Brits are teased at work.
Is it because when you weren't looking, the salesman had dipped his cock in your teeth?
I'll give you a clue. It's something that the winner of The Apprentice suffers from.
Not being able to pronounce words?
Yeah, that's exactly right. Speech impediment.
Yeah, that'll do. Good work.
Yes, the top five reasons for being bullied at work are speech impediment, accent, dress sense, baldness and ginger hair. If you're watching this, Anthony Worrell Thompson, unlucky. Least desirable car passenger.
Is it the Pope? Because whatever the weather, you've got to keep the sunroof open because of his hat.
And he's in, like, a Perspex box as well, so yeah. Did you watch Connie last night? Oh, forget it, forget it.
Right, who would you hate to be stuck in a car with?
A rapist.
I just imagine you going, oh, stuck in here with a rapist.
I can get on with Prince, Pauper or rapist. I reckon Stephen Hawking would be bad, because you wouldn't know it was him talking or the sat-nav.
To do with it's someone that's annoyed a lot of people that drive cars.
A bear.
Alistair Darling.
Correct. Oh. Yeah, the least desirable car passenger is the Chancellor, Alistair Darling. Heather Mills came second. She's a terrible backseat driver, always telling you to put her foot down. That sound tells me it's the end of the round and the end of the show, which means the final scores are Sean, Vic and Rafe have 5 points. Jason, David and Jody are the winners. They've got 7 points. To all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night. See you next week.
Watch clips from tonight's show and other Channel 4 comedy, past and present, online at channel4.com/watch online. Next, it's time for Stephanie to leave Big Brother.